Hey everyone, what's up? Matt here from SoundSwitch. In this tutorial video, we're going to be explaining what's new in SoundSwitch 2.3. So let's get into it. In this video, we're going to show you the new features included in SoundSwitch 2.3. We'll only be covering these off at a high level, but if you want more information, check out the links in the description below for detailed videos on each feature. So, we'll jump into edit mode. The first feature that we've added is a pre-built venue for the gig bar move. The attribute cues have also been pre-populated with settings for gobos, derby rotations, and lasers. We have also pre-populated the position cues with pan and tilt settings. And we've also built static looks for all of the features on this light. The static looks feature has also been improved. In static looks, you can now control all of the attributes of the lights, including individual colors on each fixture, as well as intensity, gobo, position, strobe, and any other feature that the lights have. Again, these can be controlled individually, so you can have multiple colors per static look, and you can also choose different settings based on every different light's capabilities. Under the Performance tab, we have included a number of new effects. The first one is the movement effect, where you can now apply a movement effect to your lights on the fly. You can right-click and select which effect you would like to add, and you can toggle this on. We've also added a color hue filter effect. When you turn this on and adjust the color, the output of your lights will be filtered based on the hue. We've also added the ability to select the color for each of the color overrides. You can now change these and manually set the color, and you can also toggle these on or set them to press mode. In press mode, the lights will simply switch on and off as you hold the button, and in toggle mode, you can toggle these buttons on and off. We've also added a feature for position overrides. You can now select and override a position on the fly and also choose which position is assigned to each button. At the bottom of the screen, you can also see that there are a number of group intensities. These group intensity controls correspond with the new control groups that can be set in the DMX map. Here, I can set my left washers to group 1, my gig bar to group 2, and I can set my right pass to group 3 and even group 4. This will allow me to control and dial in the intensity of each one of my fixture groups individually. You can do this at a group level like I have with group 1, where both of the lights in the left-hand group are now dimming, or you can set them so that you can control fixtures individually. We have also updated all of the default auto loops. You can reset your default auto loops by selecting Options and then resetting the default auto loops. We have also added the ability to connect to Philips Hue Smart Lights. Select the Hardware tab, select Enable, and then you can connect to your Philips Hue bridge, and your lights will be automatically discovered and shown on the screen. We have also made improvements to the auto scripting feature. You can now select the auto option and select a preset from the basic menu without having to go into the advanced menu. Once you apply the automation, SoundSwitch is now applying more effects based on the fixture category. If you switch to the DMX map, you can see the fixture categories listed here. If you change the fixture categories for a particular light, SoundSwitch will apply different effects based on those categories. If I rescript this track, you can now see that the effects on these particular lights here, now that I have changed the category, have updated. We have also added controls to the UI that allow you to zoom without using a trackpad or hotkeys. If you have DMX fixtures that are cross-patched, SoundSwitch will now display the DMX icon in yellow, letting you know that something's not right in your configuration. We have also changed the way that duplicating attribute queues work. You can now duplicate an attribute queue, and the settings within the attribute queue will also be duplicated. We have also changed the way that SoundSwitch stores your data. You can now create a new project or open a project, as well as save or save a project as something like a backup or as a secondary project. You can also export a project. If you would like more information on the features in SoundSwitch 2.3, please check out the links in the description below. If you have any questions, please reach out in the comments or send us an email to support@soundswitch.com. You can also join the user group on Facebook or send us a message on Instagram or Facebook Messenger. Thanks, and we hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you in the next one.